Baby, I the color for your love.
Color.
I the mad for your love.
Baby, I the color.
I dey always expect these things. Normally.
Hi. Hello. Hey boo, welcome back to my channel. My name is Adanna. And if it's your first time stopping by, wait. This hair is sweeting me. So hello. Y'all, today we found the hack, as in the real secret. If you've been struggling to do fitting braids, stitch braids, cornrows, this hack is for you. If I want to see how we achieve this very simple hairstyle that you can literally do in 30 minutes and you're good to go, then please keep on watching. And without further ado, my darling, let's get started.
For this hairstyle right now, I went ahead to part the center of our natural hair right there all the way to the back. You see these stitch braids, I have those lines in between. I've never been able to get them for the life of me. Like, they're just so hard. It just like my fingers are never cooperating whenever I try them. So I find that this hack has just been the life saver. So for this cornrow technique that we're going to be doing today, all you need to do right now is to start parting your natural hair. We're going to do about 7 steps. If your natural hair is a lot thicker, of course you can go up onto 8 to 10 steps depending on how many lines you want in between your cornrows. I also wanted mine to be fast. I didn't want anything that would just take too long, so we just did like 7, parted our hair right there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and the 7th one is that first one that we had left out in front. I went ahead to use some jam. Just apply some of that jam gel right there onto each of this section. You know, plaster it so it's flat, it's laying really nice and sweet. Then grab your elastic band. Use that to hold each of these strands right here that we've segmented and parted out into a ponytail. Okay, hold each of them right there like it's a ponytail. And I went ahead to repeat the exact same thing onto the right side of our head right here. Is this the right or the left? But yeah, I went ahead to repeat the exact same process onto this other side of our natural hair. And voila, this is the time for the real work. For this entire hair extension that we're using today, it is from Vivace. Shout out to them for partnering up with us in today's video. I love how soft this synthetic hair is. Like, it feels good, okay? This is in color 1B. It is pre-stretched, so we don't have to do any stretching. 100% canna colon hair, and it's the 3x pack, so literally all we used for this hairstyle was just that one pack. We didn't even finish it. I literally ended up using 1.5 from the entire bundle. Moving on right now to the real work, grabbing each of these hair extensions. So the first thing you want to do is to grab a chunk of hair, making sure that you're actually measuring, because you know, just like feeding braids, when you start from the front extension is supposed to be small, and then as you keep going, the sizes are supposed to be increasing. So that's exactly what we're going to be doing. So the back right here has to be the thickest hair extension. Like, this is where you need to have more of this hair extension. And to put in this hair extension right now for our feeding braids, we're going to go ahead right there, grab your crochet hook, and then start to crochet this hair extension onto each of these ponytails. As you keep on going towards the front, the sizes of the extension should be reducing in size. I mean, that's what makes it fitting, right? Because as you start cornrowing from front to back, the extension keeps increasing in size. So right now, we're applying the extension from back to front, which means that the sizes of the extension for each ponytail should be reducing. I hope that mathematics is mathematicing. But keep adding your hair extension, keep adding it to each of these ponytail. Do it up until you get to the very front one. The very front one, which I mean, is the 6th one. We have 7 strands of ponytail. So the very first one that is not with any elastic band, we're not going to attach any extension to it. And I'll be sure to explain to you in a bit why we'll not be adding any hair extension to that very first one. You see this one? We're getting there, almost there. Once we are done with this one right now, okay? Yes. Go ahead, put in your crochet hook, grab this hair. And if you all notice, we keep on adding in the hair extension. So there's no specific, like just keep adding to you, depending on the thickness of hair that you want to achieve. I wanted mine to be pretty thick. It's just 2 cornrows, right? So I kept adding, like literally for each ponytail, some of them you can add once if that works for you. Some of them I added like 2 to 3 times because I also want the flow of the feeding to look seamless. And for this very first one right here in front, we didn't add any hair extension, neither did we add any elastic band, just because this is your edges. I'm so particular about edges. Girl, please, let's save these edges in 2024. We cannot be taking them out. And I feel like the elastic band for that tiny strand of hair just feels like a lot of tension. So anything to avoid so much tension on our natural hair, especially our edges, my sister, run away. Run away, please. Y'all, that first one was the biggest struggle of history. Like, I struggled. I took this down. I redid it again. It was a lot of trial. At some point, I was like, you know what? Let me just focus and get this done perfectly well off camera. Then I will come back and show you all the struggle that we just passed through. So let's do this all over again together. To make sure that we're carrying everyone along and everyone is following, we're going to go ahead right now to start crocheting. To crochet this hair extension onto each of our natural hair ponytails. We're going from the back to the front. You could go from the front to the back. It all depends on you. But you also want to make sure that as you're going forward, the hair extension is reducing in size. If you're coming from the front to the back, the hair extension needs to be increasing in size. That is what makes it feeding braids. Your hair extension keeps increasing as you're going. So we went ahead to crochet this Vivace hair extension onto each of our natural hair ponytails. Some places we put like 3 strands of this. Some places I literally just put 1. But the main thing is need to make sure their sizes are going in the pattern that we just explained. Starting off with our natural hair cornrows right there in front, we're going to go ahead to do like a 3-stranded one step braid right there in front. There is no elastic band on this first one to reduce what? Tension. And once you do that first 3-stranded braid, you're going to go ahead to grab a tiny bit of this hair extension just like you do for your regular feed-in braids. Attach this right there, so place it, okay, using like your right hand, then use your left hand to make a one step braid just like so, okay, and then grab the other side of this extension that we had left right there on the right and peg it underneath this cornrows and then keep on cornrowing. keep on doing what cornrowing. So once you have done about 5 steps of this add-on, which is usually the difficult part. Once you've done the 5 steps of this add-on, my darling, just cornrow the rest of your hair. You don't have to keep on adding on anything else because the rest of our cornrows right here already has more than enough hair extensions to get us through it. So you just go ahead right now to cornrow this all the way to the very end. One thing I want to mention is while cornrowing your hair or doing your feed-in braids, try to like touch a little bit of shine and jam gel. So like touch the gel and keep using it to cornrow your hair. I feel like it makes it a lot neater just because our natural hair sometimes it can get a bit fuzzy, which is okay. But if you want that, you know, sleek look, just touch a little bit of shine and jam gel and then go ahead to keep on doing the cornrows. In that way, you're also ensuring that your natural hair is well secured, it's well tucked in, and it's laid perfectly flat. Yo, can y'all see how easy that was? And then once you're done, of course, plait this hair all the way to the very end. One part I try not to forget is actually dabbing the cornrows with hot water. This helps to lay down flyaways. It also helps to ease tension. So let's say, for example, maybe you felt like you did yours a bit too tight. This is just going to help that blood flow. So your hair can just zzzz. You feel the blood flowing in your scalp. Like it just helps to aid a lot of things. After which, we're going to go right now to apply some hair mousse. This hair mousse also helps to lay down flyaways. Make sure that you've trimmed all the ends, all the flyaways that are just poking left, right, and center like they have no manners. Trim all of that, secure this, apply your hair mousse, and I tied this down and went to bed. And this is the following morning. I feel like the hair needs a little bit of touch up this morning. So I'm going to go ahead right now and still do the edges a little bit, you know, just a little swoop swoop. Because I feel like the edges kind of like got ruined in the shower. So I touched up the edges a little bit. Use this silk wrap. Is it silk wrap? What they call this thing? This paper wrap from Red by Kiss. It was also sent to me by Vivace. Shout out to them. So I went ahead to use those strips to ensure that this hair is properly secured. I tied about 4 of them, 3 or 4, and just secured this cornrows to make sure that it's flat, it's staying secured. Ah, this hairstyle now. Some the hairstyle is sweeting me. And here is like 1 hour later, makeup is done. A girl is looking real baked and nice. This is the final product. Oh, y'all. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. This hair. Why do God? Why happened to you? We supposed to vibe together. Say for jingy. For jingy. The party. That party is not striking. That's parts. But we thank God at least the thing made sense. Because I had such a hard time with this hairstyle.
It's my very first time trying this, y'all. The very first cornrow that we did. Hey, I loosened it and I did it again. I unraveled and it just wasn't making sense at first. But once we got a hold of that very first few steps for that very first cornrow, everything flowed so seamlessly. For this second hairstyle, so we're going to be styling this hair in 2 ways. You can have it all down like we have going on here. Look like a schoolgirl.
But I wanted to give you this bun look. Like, the bun look was the ideal look I had in mind for this hairdo from the get-go. Like, I feel like it's just elevated the look to a different level. So I went ahead to wrap this hair, grab it first of all, use an elastic band, hold both hair strands of your braids together, and then go ahead to wrap this all around. Wrap it. Then using an elastic band again, conceal that, as in to seal it and to hold this bun down there. And then went ahead to use some free spray. I just used that free spray just so the bun doesn't move as much. It also gives the bun that bit of stiffness and security. And then I went ahead to use this oil sheen spray. Spritz right there all over our braids. Just give it that nice sheen. And of course, let's not forget, we have to do what? Accessorize this hair. To accessorize this hair, I went ahead to add the silver dots. Just a little poop right there at the bun, and this hair was a finito. Come on. No. Just let me know down below in the comment section. Where are you going to wear this hairstyle to? Like, just tell me, because I feel like this hair is about to cause havoc everywhere. That's basically for this video, y'all. Thank you so much for watching. Thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Comment. Let me know down below in the comment section if this particular method inspired you to finally try those stitch braids I want to hear. And again, shout out to this person. Oh my god, I need to find that channel real quick. Give me a quick second, my darling. Inkem Jeffrey inspiring this technique. And also, all the details to this hair extension from Vivace is going to be linked down below in the description box for your reference. Please go check them out, grab your hair extension, and let's get these protective styles protecting this winter season, okay? Let me know down below in the comment section as well if you'll be trying this method of cornrows, or if you've even tried it before, how was it for you? I'm so curious. This is my very first time, and I'm impressed. I just wish the pattern, the bits, you know, a bit better, but I think we can work with what we have, right? Thank you all so much for watching. Thumbs up, comment, subscribe, and I will see you, my loves, in the next video. Bye.